Tom here from Learn Systems, and I'm here to issue a correction regarding the Plex UPnP DDoS attack. Plex reached out to me to correct something. Now, too long didn't watch. If you just want to know what the answer is, UPnP was not a factor. This was kind of a misconstrued from the NetScout report that I then reiterated again. So there's a chain of incorrect information, and I don't like incorrect information. Therefore, this is the correction video. Essentially, UPnP opens up TCP port 32400, and that's it when you have UPnP enabled. The other ports being open are a problem, but they were not open automatically. And now I'm going to get to the exact email that Plex sent me. Plex saw your video and noticed at the 3-minute mark, you state that Plex uses UPnP to automatically open up UDP access on irrelevant ports, and this is not the case. The original NetScout report made some material errors that were misleading to network operators and grossly overstated the threat. Unfortunately, they did not reach out to Plex before issuing their misleading report, so we do not have the opportunity to avoid the confusion. In their report, it was correct to state that if a Plex media server is accessible over the public internet and port 32414 is accessible, yes, it can be attacked and used in this DDoS attack. They go on to say that, well, as I just stated, only 32400 TCP is what UPnP opens, and it's misconfigured firewalls, or people have no firewall at all and just Plex on a public IP address that causes this issue. I'll leave the full text here if you want to read it word for word down in a link below, along with the forum post that is relevant to this. In short, if you update your Plex server, you're fine. Also, if you don't misconfigure your firewall and you don't put your Plex on a public IP address with no firewall at all, you're fine. These are perfectly fine to have Plex Media Server with UPnP because as of right now, February 17th, 2021, there are no known attacks against TCP 32400, the port needed for remote access to Plex. I see that right now because there could be some problem in the future. I never like to rule that out where someone's watching this 2 years from now. I'm like, oh, I remember when he said that. And next thing you know, they found a vulnerability. Anytime you publicly expose anything, there's always a potential for issues or abuse if a flaw is found in a thing that you publicly exposed. So as always, keep your servers up to date, keep an eye on the security bulletins, really stop and think if you need to have something opened up. That's just good hygiene for security. Just keep it all closed and only open up the things that are relevant. And in the case of these 27,000 servers, lots of people have lots of things open. And well, someone found all those open things and exploited this. So I'll leave a link to the other video. I'll leave a link to the text down below in the first top comment here and the forum post related. And that is all. I just wanted to get this correction out there. Thanks. And thank you for making it to the end of the video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you'd like to see more content from the channel, hit the subscribe button and hit the bell icon if you'd like YouTube to notify you when new videos come out. If you'd like to hire us, head over to lawrencesystems.com, fill out our contact page, and let us know what we can help you with and what projects you'd like us to work together on. If you want to carry on the discussion, head over to forums.lawrencesystems.com where we can carry on the discussion about this video, other videos, or other tech topics in general. Even suggestions for new videos, they're accepted right there on our forums, which are free. Also, if you'd like to help the channel out in other ways, head over to our affiliate page. We have a lot of great tech offers for you. And once again, thanks for watching and see you next time.